This Tiny Teach is going to cover activation of cytotoxic T cells. To be activated, cytotoxic T cells must recognize epitope in MHC class 1. Now let's get started. When a cell is infected with a virus, it displays viral epitopes on its surface in MHC1. When a cell is abnormal, it displays I am abnormal epitopes on its surface in MHC class 1. Part of activation of cytotoxic T cells is T helper 1 cells. They actually produce cytokines or lymphokines, chemical signals that help activate the cytotoxic T cell. So let's take a look at that. Here's my activated helper T cell. This is a T helper 1 cell. It's producing chemical signals that are going to help us activate this cytotoxic T cell. When we activate the cytotoxic T cell, besides using the chemical signals from a T helper 1 cell, we also have to have a match between inactive cytotoxic T cell and infected or abnormal cell. It's similar to the match that we saw in activating helper T cells. So here's my infected cell. This could be an abnormal cell as well. It's displaying an I am infected or I am abnormal epitope in MHC class 1. We need to find the right inactive cytotoxic T cell. So the cytotoxic T cell has its T cell receptor and its CD8 co-receptor. So let's look at this match a little more carefully. Here we are seeing the match in a bigger view. Here's my infected cell. Again, this could be an abnormal cell, but it's displaying viral epitopes in MHC class 1. It needs to activate the right cytotoxic T cell that can kill it. The cytotoxic T cell has T cell receptor and CD8 co-receptor. So a match happens when an epitope, an MHC class 1, perfectly from the infected or abnormal cell, perfectly matches the cytotoxic T cell receptor, and CD8 co-receptor. So you can see the epitope fits perfectly into the cytotoxic T cell receptor, and the CD8 co-receptor comes around and binds to the MHC class 1 protein. When this all comes together, along with the chemical signals from the T helper 1 cell, this inactive cytotoxic T cell is activated. It divides by mitosis to produce clones. Some of the cytotoxic T cell clones become memory cells, and they wait around in case the same antigen is encountered again in the future. The majority of cytotoxic T cell clones become active cytotoxic T cells that travel around the body looking for more of this exact infected cell or this exact abnormal cell. The match is going to help the active cytotoxic T cell make sure that it kills the correct cell. So if this cytotoxic T cell thought, wait, this is the infected cell I'm supposed to kill, it would know that for sure because epitope and MHC class 1 would fit perfectly into T cell receptor and CD8 co-receptor. Then the cytotoxic T cell would kill the infected or abnormal cell using chemicals, perforins that make holes in the infected or abnormal cell membrane, or granzymes that cause apoptosis of the infected or abnormal cell.